All right. Well, kind of a weird day here. My internet is so crap that I can't stream. But anyways, welcome to the 294th day of Making Songbringer. I'm just gonna actually record this for YouTube only. So I just tried to stream. I couldn't get it to work. There's crazy rain and there's crazy wind, so I'm thinking maybe there's some kind of tower down or something. So I'm just replying to people on chat here, but I'm mostly gonna, I think I'm not even gonna chat because it's like nobody can see what I'm doing anyway, so. So, but anyways, what I'm working on today is art, doing lots of art for the levels. And like I'm gonna do let's get in the game, I'll show you what I mean. I'm working on the level walls, and you can see I added some big old pillars here in the middle. These pillars. So I'm just trying to make the art look a little more uniform here for level one. I'm gonna take these fire sconce pillar things and make them cooler. Maybe even make them so they can be on the walls. And then adding in like a skeleton. I'm gonna add little skeletons to the tops of the walls randomly. It's just, you're not even gonna collide with them. It's just like a little decoration. Yeah, so just graphics. We're going on graphics today. Somebody just in the chat just suggested to make the shadows flicker, and they used to. It looks like they, oh, wait, there's an example of one of them flickering a little. Yeah, so it looks like somehow it got turned, the flicker got turned off for some of the sprites. So I'll figure out what that is. What? Alan Rickman? Can't just lose Alan Rickman and David Bowie. This is crazy. Right, so let's get started here. Yeah, so I'm working on these bits of art for the walls, and I think I made them a little bit too light. Especially that one. Maybe this one. Ooh, you can hear that rain outside. I just don't need to run the game all day. I don't know how something happened to the icon. Yeah, overall, I want to lighten these up a little bit. Well, it's gonna be kind of a quieter day. So I'm just gonna, you know, kind of draw and stuff. There's really no one to talk to on the chat. So this might be a lot more of a silent kind of video than usual. Maybe I should even turn off my picture in the lower left corner. I don't know. Oh, wow. Just noticed this glow is a little bit dark on the edges. Anyways, okay, the walls. The walls look better now. They look kind of weird now. I feel like I messed them up. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go backwards in time on this and just apply a tiny bit of hue, but not change all the artwork as drastically as I just did. It kind of looked good before, and there's something missing about this. Ah, no, I guess I could tweak it a little bit. Let's tweak it a little bit. Let's get up the... I gotta get a drink of water. Thirsty, one sec. Cold and wet outside, I'm hot inside. What's with that? Get this hot old coat on. All right. Okay, I want to look at which wall I like the best. Turn off the chat, just focus. So there's this triangular one. A square one. I think I'm gonna make this whole image a little bigger so I can see them all at once. Just get these all renamed up so it's easy to export this document. Turn off slices. Now I can edit away. The only thing that sucks is now I have to draw on every layer. Well, here, let's duplicate all these. Hide all those originals. Now I can just edit one layer at a time. Right, I still got those layers or slices. Yeah, cool. Okay, much better. Now I can edit one layer, much more simple. I think I like the leftmost layer the best. Of all these, that's my art instinct says. Art instinct says. I think I heard thunder. Sweet. Yes. Thunder, lightning. Definitely hearing lightning. This is sweet. Whoa, what's up? I guess somebody just followed right now. I'm not even streaming, but this is kind of crazy to put this highlight down here, but maybe it works. Oops, well, that's too right. Hey. Yeah, so if you're just like checking out this YouTube video, maybe you skipped ahead or something. I'm drawing today, but my internet sucks so bad I can't do any live streams. So I'm still recording this for YouTube for later. I guess I could merge in the whole top and everything too, and in this whole single document. That would make it really easy to work with. So if I put wall top, it's wall top. Here we go. One wall top. Just copy and paste this whole thing and slice it up again. Oh, look at that. It's exactly what I need. Of course it is. All right, so let's put that about there. Let's make this document just a lot taller. Whoops. Take this wall top 2 document as well. I'm just gonna have to create slices for all these. So the reason I'm doing this, I'm kind of like reworking this art, is I'm making it easier for myself to just export, to create new dungeons. It's to make things as easy and frictionless as possible to create new art. So now that I've got all this whole wall in one document, I'll need to go create layers and stuff to make it just all export correctly. But this is beautiful because all I got to do is go into one document after this. I'll have to touch up this art as well, but all I got to do is go change one document, re-export, and I got another dungeon's walls. So this should be really, really handy. I don't really need the timeline window for this kind of editing today. This doesn't really animate, but I guess it could. I could do a whole another document or something. I don't know. Yeah, the easiest way would be to create another document, make a second frame. Okay. So yeah, I'll need to redraw those, but first, let's create a slices folder. See how big this slice was for the wall top before? There's one wall slice. Well, I really need a new layer-based slice hotkey. I use that all the time. I think I'm gonna go. So I use Command L to hide and show my slices. I'm gonna use Option L to create a new layer-based slice. Where is it at? Workspace, keyboard. New layer-based slice. That's in the layers window. Wait, this is tools. What application menus, layer. It's way. That was deep. Option L. Oh, this was already Command Option L. What? Ouch. Guess Command Option L will have to do. All right, I got it. I got it. I got it. So right now I'm pressing. I love creating less friction with my work, as you can obviously tell. This is way deep. There it is. So I'm gonna make this Command L, and then I want to change View Show Slices. Change that to be Command Option L. And save my workspace. Actually, let's turn on the timeline. This is my default workspace, like this. In fact, I wonder if I can do that. Then go Window, Workspace, new workspace, save all this. Because you never know when Photoshop's going to just lose it. Replace it, yeah. Cool. Okay, so now. Yeah, I can go Command J to duplicate, Command L to make a layer. JL. It's way smoother. What's nice about this document too is it uses all of the pixels. Every single bit of this is used up. So I don't have to go and X and remember to choose all user slices every time. So I can just, once this is all set up, it's gonna be super easy. All right, so I'm gonna rename all these. This one's 0. Oh wait, I gotta go to my slice tool. Let's save that. Okay, so this is one wall, top 0. I believe. And let's see how I did it before. One wall top, show slices, slice tool, level wall top 0, right? And then the other one, slices for this one, level top, wall top 1, 2. Let's keep that convention. Okay. So now I go back to one wall. This is going to be easier. One wall. This is 1, 2. Actually, now it's going to be faster for me to use the mouse for that, this little part. 3, 4, 5. 6. Man, I feel like I'm in the zone. Been live streaming every day for like a year. Whoops. So I just know how to say what I'm doing really easily. Because this is one wall. 1, 0. 1, 1. 1, 2. 1, 3. 1, 2. All set up. I'm not gonna double. I'm gonna double check them when I export, so I can turn off my visibility of those. Hide all these slices. It's probably a little art to the top of this, so change all these colors. Let's merge these. Now select all the same colors. Modify all this at once. This is the color, the highlight color. Okay, so the next color down would be, let's put this above that. This right here. Oops. Next color down. This one was, I'm only gonna do a little bit. I'm gonna make a new color for this. Just barely different. does not look much different, but it is. And this darker color is gonna be something like this. Already used that, huh? Oh, that's right. Let's do this for the darker color. Actually, we'll go all the way dark for the darker color. Maybe darker. See how that looks, how it exports. Now I need a render video. Kind of wish those were the same thing. Render video and whatever that other thing is. Wall, one wall. One wall zero through one, one wall top. Let's see what we got first. Get status. We've added these new one wall files. Good, we got one wall 1-20 and 2-21. Whatever the heck those turned out to be, you're wrong. I'm gonna take a quick break, be right back. Alright, back. Today's YouTube video only. Streamed didn't work. One wall zero. Which one am I missing here? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Where'd we get this 1-20 from? Let's see what it turned out as. One wall. 2-21. Oh. It's a square one and the I forgot to name those. That's one wall one. Oh. These are all wall top. Oh, wall top. Yips. And before I was like, I got the flow. I got this. Mistakes. This is why game development takes so long. This is the friction I'm talking about. Friction, man. One wall. Top. 10. Yeah. Yeah, get rid of all these. Oops. Yeah, now we got 1, 0 through 2 tops. It's got to hook it up in the world now. This is one wall, blah, and then one wall, top, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Does that really work? Area creation, wall top. Top format frame. What's frame? Get frame with corners. Does that add tens and stuff to the sides? Kingdom Comforters plus 1 plus Kingdom Comforters. This is 8 plus 1 plus South. That's 9. I don't know. Let's see if it works. I feel like that wouldn't work, but I mean, it should, right? Ow! One wall top. Did I spell that right? Did I do that right? Maybe just didn't export right. Sometimes this is finicky how it rebuilds. Come on, rebuilder, rebuild it. That's all this stuff. We don't need this anymore. This is a 20 by 12 by 13, which is the same size as the block size of 16. So yeah, 20. This is a 2B by 1B by 2B. Easier to represent it that way, thinking of it in terms of block sizes. A little more universal. Just change the block size, change everything else. Ooh. I think it worked. Yes. It was just that. So if I turn off all the hue saturation here, turn off the showing the slices. Got the slices still. There, that's taking out all the saturation. But maybe not all of it. Maybe like keep a little. Keep the lightness the same. It's just the ground. The ground is the wrong color. Oh, wait. I'm still repacking the whole time. Yeah, the ground is not quite right anymore. That might be because of the ground color. The ground color might be really, really tied to that. What's this? I think I got one of the frames wrong there. Corners aren't working anymore. Wait. What did we have before? It was level wall, top, zero. Oh, see, this did have 9. That was 9. And then that was 10. 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. It's 9 through 17. It just continues the. Get this set right. This is not 10, that's 9. It still had a bit too much hue, anyways. Oops, well, gotta wait for it to repack. I think what it might be now is that it's the wrong color. Wait, did I get that frame right this time? Oh yeah, it looks like it's okay. Wall tops are looking a lot better. It's not doing the corners anymore though. It used to do these one little corners. And those would have been, oh, these frames, yeah. I wonder why it's not doing those. And the colors for the level are just. Where does it set those? Because this gets color type. Oh no, it doesn't. It doesn't have a render color type right here. Color, K colors, rock. Oh, but it's not even being set. Oh. So that color type to rock. Ooh, now we're starting to get it. Now it needs to be lighter. But just on the bottom. Yeah, this layer right here. So, this is easy enough. Just apply brightness contrast only to this layer here. In fact, I might make the top darker. So, brightness contrast there, same kind of thing. There should be a lot more contrast. Packing that whole time. Oh, what did it do it again? Oh, yeah, yeah. Just the walls brighter now. Walls a little brighter. This tops. Oh, that was really nice touch of the tops. But maybe this could be even lighter, actually. Nah. Man, it would really help to have another texture here. I'm gonna create another texture right now. This takes 10 seconds to render the common texture. It should be a level texture. Texture packers will be like, you haven't updated in forever. Update period expired again. Oh yeah, so let's take out, which one's this level? This is level, so we don't need, let's take out everything but how do I delete these? It took forever. Yeah, just level. Okay. We changed everything. Let's make this called level. Come on. What is taking so long? Texture packer. The hell? Just edit this by hand. Right, and I'll edit this one by hand too. And then in common.txt, I have this list of sprite sheets to load always. So I'll add level to that. So I got this texture as well. And then I can just re-export this. And it will automatically rebuild all this. All right, did this re-export? Get this texture loaded over here. sheets. Looks like we got level. Common still. Well, common won't have all these. Yeah, that's good. And then it should export to Songbringer's assets, textures, level. There's level. I wonder why it has so many boss doors. I think common should be simpler. Yeah, looking good. Alright, this should be all good. Now basically that should just make it faster when I export level textures and I have to recompile a smaller, like maybe half the textures or whatever. Alright, this is starting to look good. The background, maybe the walls. The walls. Here, just a tad bit, maybe. Maybe a tiny bit saturated now that they got the right color applied. This whole master hue saturation change, -100. Let's give it some saturation, maybe half the saturation. Maybe all the saturation. Let's see what happens when that happens, when it's like that and then colored. So there, it only took 8 seconds to repack the textures compared to 15 or whatever it was. Ooh, yeah, that's a little too much. It starts to go with the rock color. I guess it's the ground color that's different. Yeah, it's just the ground color now. This is the ground color needs it to be complementary. Yeah, now we gotta start working on the color. So basically, let's take a screenshot here. Just to see how it was. No, I got too many things open anyways. Yeah, so the ground color needs to be more complementary than that. And then I would like to do some, I like these big tall pillars now in the middle, but I'd like to do some sconces. And I like for these shadows to flicker. And then I'm going to put like a skeleton in the corner. And then I'm going to play with like having an actual wall sconce. So a tiny flame in a wall sconce would be sweet. Yes, this is fun. Oh, yeah. Oh. There's colors. Text. Something's like that might be what it's applied. By a little tiny drone. By the way, for the YouTube video, oh my god, I started using Trello. Love it! It's so great! It's really nice to be able to visually make all my to-do list into something that I can quickly look at and go, okay, all these green items I can do quickly and or they're things I want to do right now. Red items need to be done like immediately. These are like urgent, like really important items. Right now I'm just having fun though and doing art. Yeah, so I gotta find the place that it's going and grabbing these colors, because it's not grabbing it from here, the actual colors list. But it either should be, or this colors list should be part of the world data now.
What's up, baby?
Sort of. The internet's out again today, so I couldn't stream, but I'm actually still just recording it for YouTube anyway, so.
What do you mean the internet's out? No,
it'll work for that, but it's not strong enough to be streaming. Second day in a row.
And ask them what's going on.
Yeah. No, okay, good money for that.
Right. Oh my god, so much work too.
So yeah, it's recording in here, so I'm just gonna shut the door off.
Okay.
So I need to set a breakpoint, figure out what color it's applying. I think it's in world. Some function where it gets the colors. Oh, here we go. Parse colors, get colors. So parse colors. Parse colors also prepares some general, generates colors for level one and all that. Or like randomly does color schemes. I think I'm gonna make this. Oh yeah, I think I'm gonna move this right now into. It's good enough to check. I'm gonna check in the existing code. Changes made to levels and all that. Actually, I should delete any extraneous frames that I'm not using anymore from the level. Got all these wall tops, so that should be changed. Tiles, all this stuff can be renamed. Whoa. Oh, I forgot it does this. I wonder if the boss door even does that animation. Okay. I'm not gonna go tweak this art too much more right now. I'm not gonna go change all these file names right now when I really want to make art. So I think this is clear of door. I did all the walls, basically. I renamed the walls, so that's good enough for a check-in. Yeah. All right, good. So next up, colors. So right now it pulls the colors from the level, the colors file. The colors file should be no longer. Let's go to colors. Colors. Go back to world. So the overworld, maze, ground, colors. This is how it should be. So each section of the world here has its own list of colors. And so now the same thing. This is like per style type. I could be smarter how it loads these, but we don't need to be too smart for the levels. And for the levels, let's go just to cave, stone. All it needs is this. Five colors per level. Right now, I guess I should output like approximately what it's doing for its colors. Maybe not. No, yeah, it's rock color and everything is pretty important to just to export all these. This is color size 1 less than 0, I less than num colors. 15 different color types. Okay. And then K colors 1 to push back. Style map. Okay. So it's doing 13 different style maps based on all these colors. Okay, so I'm gonna log all these out. Color is gonna be words. Okay, color types. Doesn't allow me to quick load that, damn. So this is a reverse lookup. I should have a function for that. I've done this before, I know, so I should make a function real quick for like reverse lookup. Struct words has its own from compister. Let's do also reverse lookup, which would be static. It's gonna return a string, the name, given a integer 64T type. Which there's a map rev type, which just says on automatically. Oh, and it's also going to need to take a map type. So const. Oh, it's already a map type. Sorry. Const. There. So it's, it takes the map type, looks it up by integer 64 type I, and then returns it. I guess this could be a const string ref. Turning an empty string. Yeah. There, nice and efficient and all that. Get that compiling. Constants, words. Let's do this function. Do this thing. Do this. What? Oh, there's a, that's all these constant methods. Where's the, let's do a words method. Const string ref. Words, reverse lookup. Given a map type. This is pretty easy. I think there's find. Yeah, I think there's a, I think there's an STL method for that. Slow compile. Slow compile because I'm recording this. Expected expression, what are you talking about? What are you talking about? It second should be the, oh, it should be it first. Just hitting hit escape and let it show me what that type is that it found. Jesus, this takes forever to compile with streaming. I never noticed because I'm always chatting and stuff. Dude, well, this is like extra slow though. Something is going up. Something's up. Must be. Either that or I'm just impatient. No, but it's just compiling. Clang, 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 clang. Clang, 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 clang. First, escape. Escape, 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 escape. Dude, what? What? Maybe I did this wrong. Oh, it's still indexing. I don't think I've ever had it take that long just to recompile and re-index the project. Adding a single method to the one header. God, I would love if this were more faster. I wish I had a bit of less friction. See, that's the biggest problem with C++. So much friction. I mean, to make your project, oh man, don't get me started. There. Oh, of course this find is wrong. Okay, it's just for auto ref word in words. If it first, no, second, it's second. It's a reverse lookup. Eight second, come on. Here. Equals I return it first. There. Oh, this is W second now. Man. Should that have taken 5 minutes? No, I don't think so. Okay, so this is gonna be words, verse lookup. Words, color, color types. And then the color we're looking for is pair.first, yes. And the value is gonna be pair.second. Turned into hex, damn. Do I have a hex method? Oh, don't tell me I gotta go recompile the whole project, created a handy little hex method. Kit.h. I have RGB. Hopefully I wrote a reverse for that. Damn. All right, get ready to snore. I'm not gonna wait for it to do its index until I finish though. Okay, there, that's all of a hex method as soon as that's done. And this is just gonna be hex pair.second. There, so whole point of that was just to export the colors I'm currently using, throw those into the new world.txt, and boom, all the levels will have their own color scheme set up. It won't be all procedural until I go and make a new one for each kind of level, but then once I have this all set up, it's going to be pretty damn easy to go and create a new art style for a whole dungeon in one day, I would imagine. So that's going to be sweet. That's going to be really cool. Oh, and this is going to be .caesar. All right, that's cool. Anything else I can do art-wise while that's getting installed? Oh, I wanted to do some skeletons, so I could do a skeleton. This is nice. I like it. I like it already. This is from a different drawing I did a while ago. Never completed it. So it's gonna be cool though once I do. Just rock it with the mouse for a second. Is this color? Let's get a darker color, like little that. Wait, was I drawing at 50% the whole time? Just lost myself in a 50% doodle. Okay, we got a skeleton. Let's export this guy. Should be in level. It's more of a common thing. Skeleton zero. There's gonna be many of these types. All right, let's see what colors we had before for all 13 of these levels or whatever. Please put the title. Index. Now, get colors. How does this work? We'll figure it out in a second. I wonder how it works for levels. Map, get map Z. Oh, okay. So Z is it's just the Z. Get map Z, return its each one has a style. All right, let's hold on. Let's see what this does, but also grab these colors. There we go. 0, 1, blah, 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 blah. You know, it doesn't matter. I could probably change these hues really fast. It does not really matter that much how that existing system works. So, yeah, let's go to world.txt now. Stone. You got your own colors, stone. There you go. Stone is the first like code name or whatever for the first dungeon's art. Okay, so back there to world. Now color's gonna have to load differently. It's never gonna generate colors. So funny, all that work to go just get those exported. Here's some default colors. This is K style none. I guess that's fine. Yeah, this is really easy. So auto ref tree is going to be world.data. Let's use world data. No. Get data. There we go. World get data dot query. Oh, it's going to be for each one. All right, there's no need to parse colors then, even. Wow, this is easier than I thought. Okay, so parse colors, absolutely unnecessary now. Probably be easier just to capture Z there. Dude, why do I need to, why am I calling this get map function like this? This is ridiculous. Oh, I guess I could return. Oh yeah, it's easy to return. Okay, that's fine. Keep it like this. All right, so we're gonna grab the data for world.gateData query. Yeah, just colors. Oh, but given the style map type, so, or the, what's it, style keys Z. This could be get child. But didn't I already do this style keys? Oh yeah, there's a get data Z. That's right. I thought that I already wrote that. Would be something handy to do. So we go world.getDataZ.query for colors. So, if this says, wow, it's good to think of this a different way. Colors clear, that's fine. I'm not even gonna do a lambda function anymore. I think I already wrote a strings for style types. Why don't you check that? Styles. Yeah, so we got light one, light two. So where are we grabbing this m.find style? Okay, so yeah, it's given a style. So really, we need to look up the right colors map to use based on the style. If it's the overworld, it's going to have a bunch of different styles per the style type. And we should rely on the style type, really. And then the levels, you don't even need to worry about the style type at this point. So there kind of does need to be a lambda function in here for getting the colors. Given some data and given a style type. So if we already have the current style type, I guess we'll loop over a couple different style types. Let's look for the actual style and then a simplified version of the style. Let's call this style one. Style. So if it's a light style, this should be styles. Yeah, I changed my mind. Hell, simplify this even more. Sort function. So look up the current style, give a style 2 equals k style light 1. Style dark. Okay, so then looping over both these styles, looking for it in this data array. Oh, we need to look up by the word get child words. Oh, we need to reverse look up this as well. So this is words reverse lookup. Glad I wrote that. We got the reverse lookup on words style type. No, words k style z based on the style type I. Yeah. Now, if D isn't null, return D. Otherwise, just return data recurrent array as it is. So there, that looks up, should look up a style pretty easily. So now we just call get style based on data and given the style type style. Now we've got that's it. We've got the colors. Oh, I guess they got to be yeah, wow, this is all so complicated and unnecessary. Okay, oh, our output array is colors, a vector of colors. So all we got to do is loop over each one of the color types. I wonder why this didn't work. Okay, let's comment all this other stuff out too, so it's not messed up there. Okay, what's your problem with this line? Declaration shows a local variable colors. Oh, well, that makes a lot of sense already. Better? Nope. What's wrong? Non-const L value reference to type val tree can have bind or temporary type of val tree. Const auto? Yay! Okay, so now I need to, in those style colors view, now we finally need to look up, oh, and we just need to go loop over them and look for each color type. Let's go color type. C equals K color dirt. I'm just gonna do this. Let's start with zero. Much easier to loop like that. So if this has say D is equal to style colors. It's a val tree, so we're gonna look it up by getting the child of words K color types. This is also reverse lookup. Based on color type. If we got that data, push it back. All right. Let's see how this goes. Basically, if this works, we can get rid of parse colors, get rid of lots. Let's make sure world.txt is all set up. I'm pretty sure that's right. So we got colors is one single array, no styles for stone. We'll do some colors for other levels in a second here. It should be able to handle without those. Cave is also going to need to be something special. So let's put the overworld colors just back up here. Yeah, okay, this should work. Famous last words. Okay, I didn't want the breakpoint there, I wanted it here. What style? What Z? Start over. Okay, we're looking for the colors for Z1. This is an area setup. Create dungeon Z, create Z. Create. So we create the dungeons before the overworld. We're getting the colors for dungeon Z1. All right, let's see what happens. We're loading the data. Data key colors, val, children, 5, good. Dirt, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so now we're gonna get the style colors based on a style type, which is passed in as S, style type 0. Yeah, we're not looking for any kind of particular style type, and that would have been called from area setup where we called area style. And area style is none for the levels. Okay. Now where are we at? Yeah. Okay. So it's not going to be style light, not going to be style dark, not going to be mountain. It's going to loop over both of these, looking for none, none. So neither of these should work. Data.getChildWords. Let's look up this reverse lookup here. We got a words, 14 words. Dark one. Dark two, great. And we're looking for I. What's I we're looking for? 0. That's going to be K style none. Did I even do that? Color type. Yeah, there's gonna be no. So this should not even find it. Yeah, great. Returning a blank static string. For the reverse lookup, data.getChild, let's see what happens here. We're looking for string K. This is going to return null because it's not going to be able to find it. D should be null. Great. Same thing here. Great. Yeah, so yeah, we just return the data array. So now style color should be the data array that we just loaded. Didn't find any special styles, so it just returned the default style with 5 children. And now we're going to look through each one of these colors. Let's see what we get for the reverse lookup on the color types. Just return this method. Oh, I didn't show the return value. But anyways, it's looking for a get child K's dirt. Great. I think that's what I named it, right? Dirt? Yeah, good, dirt. But we're actually in stone. Gotta make this more organized. I think I might put actually all of these files into, or each one of these into their own files. Like the whole stone dungeon would basically have its own file. The overworld would have its own file. I think maybe entities though could be its own thing. I'm not sure how entities will work. Yeah, but it'd be very good to organize these even better. Okay. Continuing on. We're looking for dirt. Still didn't give me a return value there. But it did give me a val tree. Dirt, great, with val. Calling RGB with string. Yes, B3BFBE. Sweet. All right, looks like it's gonna fill us up just nicely. Problem is it had to call that multiple times, so it would probably be better to not to make it so that it loads at once just like it used to, so because that could be slow doing it on, especially on Windows. I don't know why Windows is so slow, but it just is, like these little things that it has extra checks around, and I don't know why it's so slow, but it is. Same thing, like unzipping a file on Windows is so much slower, but it could just be because it's my Mac isn't really designed for Windows or what, I don't know. Z1, there should be like 15 or so of these rooms. I wanna see Z0. Oh, it's gonna do all the dungeons. Let's run it to there. C0, okay. So we got style colors, dark one. Yeah. I think it's gonna work. Wait. Let me check this. Does D come up right? Dirt. Grass, good. Looking good. So I can run this, run around a little bit in the overworld and stuff. Wow. Golden water, it's kind of cool. Holy crap, yes, I like it actually. I like it a lot. That's a pleasant accident. The ground can be a little different color. Let's run around the overworld. Make sure all the colors are still the same, because those were the ones that were really dialed in. The level one is just all gonna need some work. Oh yeah, so we still got the grass colors. Here's a dark area. Yeah, colors are good. Mountains. Here's a mountains colors. Still good. Sand we need to look for. I think sand's down this way in this world. Here we go. Yeah, great. All the colors loaded fine for the overworld. And yeah, we got them set up so the world's way better. We can remove this RM data. Whoops. Projects, data, what was one? Weapons, game, a game, I guess. Game colors. All right, get status. Cool. So, this is ready to check in. This is an unoptimized version. I can go and optimize it later so where it would actually load the code. Well, actually, I should at least remove the old cache. This is a cache style color maps. Oh, this is pretty damn easy to cache it real quick. Type def map of given a Z map style type color 3B. Vector color 3B. Color cache. I'm not sure what these are. I'm just gonna style color map is style to color type color. No. Keep the cache the way it was, the way it should be, the way. Yeah, K default colors. Screw it. Keep them all white. You should have some default colors set up in your world.txt to run this game. Yeah. Okay. I mean, it'll just If you don't have colors, it'll all be white. So it's not a bad thing. So now going down to the world. Parse colors, this is totally not needed. We're just gonna cache colors automatically. Super easy. Use cache. So if we have it z equals k color cache find. Why isn't it load? Come on. Color cache dot find. It's not working. Find Z. Is that broken? It sure is. Why is it not like that? What? Unexpected type name? Oh, this is type def. There we go. All right, great. Now we can find it. If it z is not equal to k color cache dot end, actually, shit, we're gonna push this back anyways. There's no need to worry about doing it this all this neat old way where you don't insert a blank one. Screw that. Auto ref. Cache equals k color cache z style. If cache dot size is greater than 0, return colors equals cache. And return. Otherwise, store to the cache when we're done. Color cache z style equals colors. There, quick cash. I can get rid of so much code too. What's wrong? What's wrong? World policy parse color is no longer needed. World. Oops. Oh, that means I'm gonna have to recompile. Damn it. Start that. All right, screw all this other code I don't need anymore either. Old stuff. Yeah, colors does not even need to be its own section anymore. It should be somewhere around get data, really, is what it is. So let's get data is in this section. Oh yeah, these are all cool. So we just there. Up the top, we don't need that or any of that stuff. This could be, this should be, must be static. No need to do that. All you do is parse the world data. Foes will probably eventually be, foes is a pretty cool one to have separate. Yeah, so just world.txt has its own colors. Eventually this will become like probably separate files. Or just moving, I guess if entities were all on their own. Yeah, I guess entities could be smarter and it could like have its own Z as part of each entity, and then each entity would, I would do less indenting. I'm thinking about this world.txt file here. There's too much indenting. Like I get into this entities right here and I have no idea what I was in anymore, so like I forgot, was I in the stone one? So if each entity was actually just like this, and then it had like a Z or something. This whole door, boss door, what the hell is this? Oh, these are empty things. Guess they're empty things. Wait, stone? No, stone should have a... Oh, because I haven't set it up yet in the data. Okay, so this should still look fine. With stripping out all those color methods, adding in the caching. What happens if I run away from a boss fight? Oh. Actually, oh man, this makes me excited to have some cool boots in the game that make you run faster. Maybe not this fast, but this is kind of fun. You can really run through the game quite quickly. So it'd be sweet to have some kind of boots that maybe times and a half your speed, and then some boots that do like double your speed. Be a very interesting item to find. Yes, we're looking great. All these colors are beautiful. Loving it. All right, this is worthy of checking in now. And I get back to the art I was drawing. And now I can tweak the colors for the freaking ground that I wanted to do probably an hour and a half ago or whatever, but had to do some code to get that all lined up. I guess I should check one more thing. It should be hitting this cache. Like the second time it calls an area. Z1, great. We're hitting the cache. Should be hitting the cache a bunch. Returning. Yeah. Let's check out where we're at in the stack right here. So this is create Z. Create dungeon Z. What area is this? Let's look at each area as we do this. P would be our probably our Q. Q is going to be the current area. This is 111. Go back to create dungeon Z. Oh, or just area setup. 121. 021, yeah, we're hitting the cache just fine. Cool, glad that's being reused. Good, so that code works to cache its colors. It works visually once it's all loaded. I can get rid of all this other color crap. And now each level can have its own custom color scheme. Stone would have its own color scheme, and then for now, the stone would all look the same. For basically for the whole world, because there's really it's duplicating stone over and over and over and over. But eventually, once I have all the data as separate, each one will have its own color scheme. Okay, so going back to that level I was at level one. I'm gonna go back to the area. Oh, I just thought of something. Oh, this is cool. I like being right here for a minute. Oh, and I forgot about the gold too. Oh, let's see, ran backwards, that's funny. That's pretty cool. All we need now is a ground color that's like sort of similar to these wall colors, but not too similar. Door colors could be regular door. Oh, I think the regular door colors already are based on the dirt or the wall or something. Okay, so in world.txt, what color is it making this ground? Dirt, grass, rock, plant, dirt, I guess, is the dirt color. So rock is a rock color. Oh, dirt and rock are the same? Kind of crazy. But can we mess with this? Wait, can we mess with this and change the color of the ground? Is this just like totally gray? What is this color? Ooh, it's very bluish. Very bluish. Why is it so bluish? Why isn't the rock colored like that? Oh, the walls are the dirt color, probably, or something like that. I don't know. So I like this. I like the hue I just had right there. This sort of bonish, brownish, a little brighter. Let's do this for the dirt color. Oh. Already starting to look cool. So the grass now needs some tweaks. These grass things I think could be either black even. the ground reflective? No wonder. Reflective on for the ground. How did that get like that? I have no idea. Okay, grass. I didn't like that grass color. I want something. I want a crazy, crazy grass color. Like a deep green. Deep yellowish. Sickly, poisonous green. That was too deep. Two different colors for grass and plants. Oh, this is like an alternate dirt style color. I want to blend these two colors. Let's take this color, draw it right there. Take this color, the dirt, draw it like 50%. There's a mix of those two. Might have to do it again. Yeah, or just make it brighter actually now. It's looking pretty close. Before I had B2, B6 might be too bright. No, that's not. This red color right here. Yeah, so when I do this color corridor strip thing, I want to make these strips a little different. Maybe red actually would be a sweet color for these plants and strips. Okay, I just got to find this place where it does that strip of color. No way, it's not even using that. It's using the key color for this, huh? I want to see what color that is. So it's going to be hex color. Kind of getting tired, man. I never ever get to do all the things I want to do in one stream. I really wanted to get that skeleton in there. Well, maybe I'll do the skeleton really fast. Yeah, I'll do the skeleton before I go. So that should have shown that color now. Ground. Doop, doop, doop. So this can now be First we'll go to world. Guess we'll make it the plant color. Or grass. Yeah, it's really more of a grass color. Oh, I did like this previous grass color though. Maybe that would be good for plant, if there are plants. I wonder, so these are kind of set up for the overworld, these names, these types, but they'll work for the dungeons too. Just kind of think of them differently, I guess. Maybe I could do a different word that would still, yeah. Oh, I could just map the words to the same color type for a different, to make that easier. So dirt, grass, rock. Yeah, and then when it does this strip, color equals colors K color grass. There. So now the grass and that strip will both be the same color. Ooh, yeah, what the hell happened there? Oh man, so wrong, that's not it. What? I must have copied that wrong. This room. Oh, should get the skeleton. Let's get the skeleton compiling. Like I did copy it right. This is totally wrong. How did this? What? Maybe I coded that wrong. This seems right. Looks like that is what it's supposed to be. I don't know why. Oh, 2 RGB? No wonder I had it all wrong. I wrote this hex function wrong at the beginning of the stream. This is RGB shifted up, or the R is shifted up, 16. The G is shifted up 8, and the B is not shifted up at all. Duh. I guess we could see that one more time then. Just let it run that. Prove that the hex function works now. And then, yeah, and then we'll add the skeleton tile. Oops, gotta run in the room. I guess the key colors could even be based on this. So the door right here would be... Oh, no, that should kind of be its own color. It's looking good, though. I don't know if the gold really goes with the... This is fun, though. Man, this is going to be really, really sweet to be able to change all these colors and make these dungeons even better. Alright, great. This is good enough for now. And let's add the skeleton now. So the last thing is going to be an area creation. Hook it up. Where's the hookup again? Maybe I didn't move it in here. There it is, at the very bottom. Gosh, there should be a fallback method. If you don't have a tile function, just load the data. So I wouldn't have even had to hook up this tile function. Yeah, that would be sweet. I called it skeleton. I don't want to fix it right now. All right, so the skeleton entity. No collision. No shadow. Has a reflection. Color type. No color type. Has a render, I guess. Has a position offset. Maybe not. No position for a second. Last thing is to create one of these tiles, so let's just do quickly do this in the area patterns. Pattern for the entrance. No, this is a pattern entrance for level entrance. So we put some statues. Yeah, we'll do a random chance to put a skeleton right beneath a statue. Come on, no whammies, no whammies. Just put a skeleton there. Damn it, no skeletons. How about take off the random chance, see if that was it. Nope. Okay, what if we... Oops. World.txt. Let's just set this to be skeleton 0. And let's recompile the texture just in case it somehow didn't get added lately. So data or textures common.pbr. Let's remove that. I'll force it to recompile. Skeleton images format skeleton 0. I think I can just do render image the same way. Oh, maybe it's just rendering. Oh, yeah, it's probably images is the problem. I think you can go like this, render image. Nice. They need a lot of shading, of course. Let's do this. Put back in the what if we do percent D there? I'll probably animate them. Yeah, we'll do we'll figure that out. Yeah, so back to area patterns and put that back in. So only a quarter of these have a skeleton next to them. Maybe even only one of them has a skeleton somehow. There's like one skeleton guy up there. And I'll put a random chance to flip it. Flip it. There, nice. Got a couple skeletons. Sweet. Take a screenshot. That's today's screenshot. Bam! Got a lot done today. Gotta take a break now. So, if you're watching this YouTube video, thanks for watching. Hope it's a great day you're having. And hopefully tomorrow my freaking internet works so I can stream again. Anyways, ta-ta. Have a great night. Appreciate you all watching.